but wisdom is the child of experience. In the years since man unlocked the power stored within the atom, the world has made progress, halting, but effective, towards bringing that power under human control. The challenge, in short, may be our salvation. As we begin to master the destructive potentialities of modern science, we move towards a new era in which science can fulfill its creative promise.
Hi, I'm Shane, and welcome to Relative Time. And I want to talk to you today about tritium. And that's because I noticed some reviews this last week on a new watch that was put out by Armor Light in collaboration with Mastrop. And specifically, I want to talk to you about what are referred to as gas tritium light sources, or I'll just call them tritium lume. Now, I've never owned a watch with tritium lume, but I do have a background in science, and specifically, chemistry. So I'm hoping that my insight can help clear up some confusion, especially when it comes to how long these tubes should last. So I wanted to make this video as more of a primer on everything you need to know before you start looking at buying one of these watches. And I think it's also worth noting that watches aren't really the only application for these tritium tubes. For years, they've been used in firearms, specifically handguns, as inserts in the iron sight. This is more commonly referred to as night sights. And in the unfortunate event that someone may need to draw a weapon, many people, especially law enforcement, consider them invaluable in low light conditions. But the questions and concerns apply to both applications. But let's first talk about what exactly is tritium. Now, tritium is a radioactive isotope of hydrogen. And if you're not sure what that means, let's look at the good old periodic table of elements. Now, each box represents an element. And in the upper left of each box is what's referred to as the atomic number of that element. And you'll notice that it increases by one as you go left to right, and then down to the next row. So hydrogen is one, helium is two, lithium is three. But it's not just an arbitrary number. It actually represents the number of protons that are in the nucleus of each element. And it's the number of protons in the element that give it its specific characteristics and basically define it for what it is. But it's possible to have different versions of each of those elements with the same number of protons, but different number of neutrons. And that's really what an isotope is. It'll have the same number of protons, the same basic characteristics, but weighed differently because of the number of neutrons in it. So tritium is basically hydrogen, but with two extra neutrons. So it shares the same basic properties and characteristics of hydrogen, such as being a gas at room temperature, which is why it's in one of those little tubes. But while those three extra neutrons make it three times heavier than regular hydrogen, it also makes it very unstable and thus radioactive, which is also why tritium is extremely rare in nature, and the tritium that's used in these applications is man-made. It really doesn't want to exist as itself. It would much rather decay into something much more stable, which in this case is actually an isotope of helium. But it's through this decay that energy is released, which ultimately powers this whole process. Now, you're not actually seeing that radioactive decay, and this is an outline of one of these tubes. They're really rather simple. It's basically a sealed glass tube with tritium gas inside of it, and then the inside of that tube is coated with a phosphorescent paint, much like what's on the lume of your regular watch. Now, phosphorescent paint contains a type of molecule known as a phosphor, which has the ability to absorb energy, such that's given off in this decay, hold on to it for a very short period of time, and then release that as visible light. And this process can take anywhere from less than a second up to a couple of hours, just like regular lume on a watch. Now, when you combine this phosphorescent process with a radioactive source, it becomes known as radioluminescence. And you can have different colors of light given off, and that all depends on the type of phosphors and phosphorescent paint used. Now, unlike the old radium-based paint, tritium is really rather safe. In its radioactive decay, the type of radiation that's given off is a beta particle. And while beta particles can be dangerous, in this case, it's extremely low energy, mostly due to tritium being so small. If you're exposed to it directly, it shouldn't even be able to penetrate your skin, let alone go through the case or crystal of a watch. So you almost have to purposefully do something stupid like swallow it in order to make it dangerous. Now, as you shop around, you may see the tubes being classified as T25s, or T50s, or T100s. And what that number represents is the amount of radiation in millicuries that it was giving off when it was created, which is directly proportional to the amount of tritium inside those tubes. So a T50 should have twice as much as a T25, and a T100 should have twice as much as a T50, which is usually why the higher numbers are brighter tubes. But remember, you're not actually seeing that radioactive decay. Just adding more tritium doesn't make it brighter. You still need the appropriate amount of phosphorescent paint to take advantage of the extra energy. And now the big question, which is, how long do these tubes last? And it's a tricky question, which is why if you look around, you'll see answers that range from, 5 to 50 years. And a lot of it depends on what you really define as being useful as they continuously get dimmer. Generally speaking, with the T25 tube, I would say it's too dim to be useful after 25 years. But it also depends on the situation. If you're talking gun sights and life and death situations, you may want to swap that thing out after 10 years. But let me back up, because the thing to remember is that radioactive decay is a one-way street. There's no going back and no way to recharge that tube short of drilling a hole and putting more tritium in it, which is never done. It's a whole lot easier just to replace that tube, which if you're talking a gun sight is relatively easy to do. But for a watch, you pretty much have to rebuild the entire dial. So the reality of the situation is that not only will your watch get dimmer year by year, but every month, every day, heck, even every second that goes by, there's a little less tritium in that tube. Which is more dramatic than it sounds, because you probably won't notice any difference for years. But you need to remember that this is a continuous process that starts the moment that tube is made. Now, one of the nice things about radium was that it had a long half-life of 1600 years, compared to tritium, which has a really short half-life of 12 and a half years, which means after 12 and a half years, you're going to have half as much tritium in that tube than when you started with, which means half as much energy. There's a common misconception that after another 12 and a half years, you would have zero tritium left, and this is not the case. What half-life means is that after a specific set of time, you'll have half as much material left than you started. And in this case, you're talking a half of a half, which is 1/4. So after 25 years, you'll have 1/4 the amount of tritium left. And if you follow that through, after another half-life, so 37 and a half years, you would have 1/8 the tritium left. And after 50 years total, you'd have 1/16 the amount of tritium left. Which is why I said longevity also depends, because if you're starting with a T100 tube, after 12 and a half years, it's now the equivalent of a T50. And after 25 years, it's the equivalent of a T25. So theoretically, it still has another 25 years of life left in it, but it's continuously getting dimmer. And that brings up a very important shopping tip, and that's to not only buy products from a reputable dealer, but to buy them from someone that has a very fast turnover in their stock. Because if something's been sitting on the shelf for 3 to 4 years, that's a really big chunk of its useful life that you'll never get back. Which is also why I caution buying watches that are on clearance or watches with tritium from like GearBest and AliExpress. Because not only do you not know how long the watch was sitting around, but you don't know how long the tritium tube was sitting around before it was even put in the watch, because that's really what matters. Now, the other reason I said that it depends is because ultimately it depends upon you, on not only what you consider to be useful still, but what you'd be happy with. While the lume on a T100 watch should outlast the watch, you have to ask yourself if you're still going to be happy a decade from now when that T100 turns into a T50. Now, I think tritium watches are great for specific applications, like a law enforcement officer who works at night, or if you're an avid diver. But if you're just a collector who wants one just to have one, and you only wear it a few times a month, that's where I think you really need to understand the limitations, and I hope this video helps. Otherwise, that's pretty much everything I think you need to know about tritium. Any questions or comments, you can leave them down below. It's just past that subscribe button. Otherwise, I hope you enjoyed yourself and maybe learned something, as well as I hope to see you again soon.